Dear friends and followers, welcome back to my channel and to this three-part series about what is a holding pattern, how to enter holding, and how to remain within the holding. Today, I'll be giving you a basic understanding of holding patterns and what they're good for and what this vortex machine has to do with it. So, let's get started. 1383, runway 27, take off. I'm sure many of you have experienced this before. You're on a flight heading home, let's say to London Heathrow, for example. You're in descent, you fasten your seatbelts, and then the captain announces this.
We're nice and early at the moment, so even with a little bit of holding, we should still have you on stand, hopefully 10 or 15 minutes ahead of schedule.
So picture this, 1,300 airplanes approach and take off at Europe's busiest airport every day. This means every 66 seconds a plane takes off and lands at Heathrow Airport. So imagine if there were to be a sudden snowfall and one runway would be temporarily closed due to snow removal procedures. A traffic jam in the sky above London becomes inevitable. The immediate action by the air traffic controllers would be to advise all inbound airplanes to reduce their speed to avoid potential traffic queues in the air. But snow removal can take up to 20 minutes, which equals 18 planes which are now stacking up in the sky, waiting to get their clearance to proceed to their assigned runway. And this waiting period in mid-air is called a holding. A holding is defined as a necessary procedure technique which is used to ensure a safe and orderly flow of traffic into and out of busy terminal space. And all holdings are set up in the same fashion. From above, they look like a big oval formed in a racetrack shape, which is designed to maintain the aircraft within a specified space and specified time. They can either be published on terminal plates, such as the approach and landing charts, or on an airway chart, and in some cases, unpublished and specified by the ATC controller. A typical holding pattern is based on the holding fix. The fix can be any kind of navigational aid, which is a stationary point such as a VOR, an NDB, an airway intersection, or a GPS waypoint. And starting at the holding fix, the racetrack is made out of four components. The fix end with a 180 degree turn, the outbound leg, the outbound end, and determining inbound leg to the holding fix. Determining in the sense you are flying towards the navigational aid, determining your position relative to the fix and holding. And a standard holding is flown with right turns unless otherwise specified by the air traffic controller. Also, this side is the holding side and the other one is the non-holding side. And any entry procedure, etc., will always keep you within the protected holding area. So let's look at this star of London Heathrow right here. Now let's say we're on a standard arrival Biggin Hill 1 Foxtrot and ATC advises you about the current snow removal situation on runway 27 left. Now he therefore wants you to enter the published holding over Biggin Hill VOR, so you'll check your chart for the given instructions. Now let's say for the moment there's no wind and you're at flight level 100 proceeding inbound Bravo India Golf VOR. As we are below 14,000 feet, the regulations state that the inbound leg shall be 1 minute long with a holding speed of 230 knots. Now reading off the chart, the inbound course is 303 and the reciprocal outbound course, so 180 degrees in the other direction, is 123. As we have no wind, both inbound and outbound leg are 1 minute long, but more about that in video 3. Now just to get an idea how big a holding is in size, we quickly do the calculations. Now 230 knots is our speed, divided by 60 minutes equals 3.8 nautical miles. So that's how long your legs are within the holding. So 3.8 nautical miles also equals the length of the fix end because it's 180 degrees we're turning divided by 3 degrees per second, which is the standard turning rate at 25 degrees of bank angle, equals 60 seconds. So to determine the diameter of that turn, we need to use this formula right here. Now radius r equals the circumference, now we only have half of the circumference, so that times 2 divided by 2 times pi. gives a radius of 1.21 nautical miles times 2 gives us the diameter of 2.42 nautical miles. Now, you don't necessarily need these calculations in midair, but it's nice to know how much space you're actually using up in the holding. Once you're in the holding, ATC is most likely going to give you a clearance to descend every now and then, as more planes are being stacked above you at a minimum vertical separation of 1,000 feet. Comparable to one of these vortex coin machines. The coins all circle in the same direction at a safe distance to each other, and then the lowest one falls out and new ones are added from the top. So at a certain point, ATC will then request you to leave the holding and navigate you towards the final approach. To be fair, there are a few more things you need to know as a flight student or flight simmer in terms of holding entries and how to maintain within the holding. Because if you're not flying a fancy Airbus or Boeing, where you can select the holding in the FMGS and press hold, enter, enter, and then the autopilot does it all by itself, no, you need to do all the calculations with a pen and paper. Therefore, watch the second video about the quickest way to establish the holding entry in under 10 seconds, and then the third video about how to apply wind correction angles and maintain within the holding. And here are a few more further informations and often asked questions in your ATBL theory exam or during your simulator screenings. Just press pause and read through. That's it for today. Thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video about the holdings. And don't forget, a good pilot is always learning. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.